Imagine three doors. Behind only one of them is $1 billion. So, choose a door. Like, actually choose one. For the sake of the visual, we're gonna say everyone chose this door. Now, to make things a little more fun, I'm gonna help you out. This door is wrong, so let's just go ahead and throw it away. Now, you only have two doors left, your door and the other one. Here's your final shot. Do you keep your door, or do you switch to the other? This is the Monty Hall problem, and to stop you from driving yourself crazy, the answer is that you should always switch. Because this is just not a 50-50. The actual hard part of this problem for a lot is accepting that into your heart. If you're like me, you know that the answer is to switch. You've seen the math, but it just doesn't feel right. So I'm here to help you. I've done way too much research into this topic to help other people and their brains finally get it. So let me actually explain the Monty Hall problem. I'm going to quickly cover the basic explanation that helped me truly get it, and then get into the big thing that helped me solidify my understanding. So, switching gives you a 66% chance of getting the right door. That's the math. But why? There's only two doors to choose from, so your brain might be screaming, hey, that's a 50-50. But it's important to not forget the door that we took away. The most important thing to remember is that the door that the host removes is always wrong. If this door is right and you choose this door, the host will always open the other one. Or if you choose that one and then start, the host would then open this one. This is important because it means your odds do not change. When you picked your door, you have a 33% chance of getting it right. The host then always opens a wrong door, which means it's only ever for show. It does not actually affect the chances at all. So now what you are left with is two doors. Yours is still a 33% chance, while the other door now has a remaining 66% chance. If I lost you there, don't worry, this next example should help a ton. An easier way to understand this is, ironically, with more doors. So now we have 100 doors. Don't worry, this is actually 100 doors on the screen. There is still only one door that's correct and has the $1 bajillion. And looking at this might make you start to understand how actually unlikely it is that you guess correctly. I mean, you quite literally only have a 1% chance of getting it right. If you did choose, just for fun, this is the right door. Now, back to the example. When you choose a door, we can all agree you most likely chose wrong. I mean, what's the chance you actually got it right? Again, it's 1%, I already said this. Now, the host will open up 98 wrong doors. Again, they are all and will always be wrong doors, no matter what door you choose. Now you are left with your door and another door, and for sure, one of them is correct. So now, what's more likely? That you got the door correct on the very first guess out of 100 doors, or the other remaining door? That is what this question actually is. It's always your very first guess versus the opposite. You either got your first guess out of the 100 doors correct, or the other door is the correct answer. If you got it right the first time, then the other door is wrong, which remember is only a 1% chance. If you got it wrong the first time, which is way more likely, and that means that the other door has to be right. So you have a 1% chance that you got it right the first time and a 99% chance that the other door is correct. Back to the original problem, it's the same thing. You make your 33% original guess and then you are left with two doors. Your door that you guessed with a 33% chance and then the other door, which is a 66% chance that you got the first guess wrong. So next time you face this problem, remember, after the wrong doors are removed, all the question actually is do you think you got it right the very first time? The easiest thing to think about to remember the reasoning, as you'll likely forget, is how unlikely it is to guess the correct door the first time when it's out of 100. That's the linchpin in the reasoning, is how unlikely it is that you got it right the first guess. If you're still struggling to get it after this video, put your questions in the comments and I will do the best I can to help you get it. Thanks for watching, and I really hope this helped.